Hello friends, welcome to Technique. This is Nirmal here, and in this video we're going to compare two smartphones from two iconic brands, the Moto and the Nokia. So we have with us the Moto G8 Plus, which was announced recently in India for a price of ₹13,999, and we have the Nokia 7.2, which is again launched in India a couple of months back. Now this retails for ₹17,500. So in this video we're going to compare these two devices and see what all areas these two devices excel and which is a better overall package out there. So price wise there is obviously a difference of almost 3.5k between these two devices, but what exactly is the higher price Nokia 7.2 commands? That's what we are going to talk about in this video. So first up, let's have a look at the design and build quality. Now if you look at the back panel design, you can see that the design wise the Nokia 7.2 definitely looks better than the Moto G8 Plus. Now if you look at the design of the Moto G8 Plus, you can see that this has a plastic finishing and curved back panels on the either sides, and we have the vertical layout for the camera. It feels quite good, but there isn't anything extraordinary in terms of design aspect. It's a typical design we are seeing in this budget segment, and we have a gradient finish also. And on the front panel, if you look at the front panel, we have the water drop notch, and the bezels on the top and the bottom are slightly on the lesser side, and even sides are also quite good. Now if you look at the Nokia 7.2, so this is one area where Nokia has been doing really good. The design elements looks really nice. Again, the design is subjective. Some might not like the circular arrangement for the camera, but overall this gives a really good in-hand feel. And even if you look at the front panel design as well, the bezels are also quite good in terms of the side bezels as well as the top bezels. So our choice in terms of design would be the Nokia 7.2 when compared to the Moto G8 Plus. Now if you look at the build quality, this is one area again where we feel the Nokia 7.2 is far ahead than the Moto G8 Plus. We have the glass finishing with Gorilla Glass 3 support, while we have the polycarbonate material. So there are advantages for both of these materials. Polycarbonate gets scratched easily, but it does not break easily. But on the other hand, the Nokia 7.2 has glass finishing, which can break when it falls down, but it has a much better finishing and premium looks. So in terms of the premiumness, we feel Nokia 7.2 definitely has an edge here. Now next, let's talk about the display. So we have two 6.3-inch Full HD Plus resolution display on these two devices, and both have quite similar displays as well. Both are vibrant. We have HDR10 enabled display on the Nokia 7.2. That definitely gives an advantage, and there is also a Gorilla Glass protection. While on the Moto G8 Plus, what we have been told that this is Panda Glass, which is equivalent to Gorilla Glass. So there is adequate protection on both the phones, but overall we feel again display aspect, the Nokia 7.2 has an edge over the Moto G8 Plus. So the Moto G8 Plus is not bad in terms of display, but the Nokia 7.2 definitely has an advantage over it. Now next, let's move on to the software aspect. So both the phones run on stock Android, while we have Nokia 7.2 under Android One platform. We have the stock Android on the Moto G8 Plus. Now looking at the stock Android, you can see that both are exactly the same in terms of the features being offered, except for the Moto app, which provides additional options for the Moto G8 Plus. So the Moto app is something which is really good, which provides additional options. So you can get the Moto display as well as Moto actions, which provide a lot of gestures. So that's something which is really good, which is not available on the Nokia 7.2 since it's under the Android One platform. So that's advantage. So if you're a person who likes to have some gestures and additional options, then the Moto G8 Plus offers that. But on the other hand, the Nokia 7.2 has the advantage that this is under Android One platform. That means you get security updates for the next 2 years, and Android 10 is promised for this device. While Android 10 is coming for the Moto G8 Plus as well, there is no timeline mentioned, and the Nokia 7.2 probably would be getting much faster than the Moto G8 Plus. So that's the software aspect. Now let's talk about the performance. So this is one area where there is no major difference. We have the Qualcomm Snapdragon 660 on the Nokia 7.2, while we have the 665 on the Moto G8 Plus. The 660 is an older chipset, in fact almost 2 years older. The 665 is a relatively newer chipset. That's the only difference here, but otherwise in terms of performance, both are almost similar, and even in terms of gaming experience, neither of them are stellar performers, but you can do decent gaming with PUBG Mobile on both the phones. So that's the performance aspect. So here we would say more or less equal in terms of the performance side. Now both the devices have fingerprint scanners mounted on the back panel, and both does a decent job altogether. and even face unlock is quite similar on both the phones. Now additionally, the Moto G8 Plus has Dolby support. That means it has good stereo speakers, and the sound output is really good on the Moto G8 Plus. So that's an added advantage for the Moto G8 Plus. Now next, let's talk about the cameras. So we have 248 megapixel sensors available on these two devices. You can see that the Moto G8 Plus has 48 megapixel primary camera. That's a Samsung's GM1 sensor. The same is the case with the Nokia 7.2 as well. Both of them have ultra wide angle cameras. The Moto G8 Plus has 16 megapixel ultra wide angle camera, while it's an 8 megapixel camera on the Nokia 7.2. Both have the 5 megapixel depth sensors. Now the difference in setup here is that the Moto G8 Plus wide angle 16 megapixel wide angle can shoot only videos, that's the action camera, while on the Nokia 7.2 it can take both videos as well as photos. Now on the front panel we have a 20 megapixel camera on the Nokia 7.2, while it's a quad pixel 25 megapixel camera on the Moto G8 Plus. Now looking at the camera samples, so in terms of daylight conditions, we feel both does a decent job altogether. Both are quite good, good color reproduction, but details are slightly better on the Moto G8 Plus, not by a huge margin, but still Moto G8 Plus definitely has an advantage over the camera aspect in terms of daylight conditions. Now if you move to the low light experience as well, that's also one area where the Moto G8 Plus did a better job. Noise reduction is something which Moto G8 Plus did better than the Nokia 7.2. And both of them have night mode available. And in terms of night performance, the Nokia 7.2 did a slightly better job in terms of the color reproduction. But again, Moto G8 Plus also did a decent job altogether. Now, selfie experience, again, we like the selfie experience on the Moto G8 Plus. Even the Nokia 7.2 also did a decent job altogether. So in terms of camera performance, we feel the Moto G8 Plus definitely has an advantage over the Nokia 7.2, even though neither of them are stellar performance in terms of the camera experience. Now finally, the battery life. So we have a 4000 mAh capacity battery on the Moto G8 Plus, while we have a 3500 mAh capacity battery on the Nokia 7.2. Now the Moto G8 Plus also comes with 15 watt turbo charging, while it's a 10 watt charger, that's the default charger on the Nokia 7.2. So without doubt, the battery performance is slightly better on the Moto G8 Plus. Additionally, you also get 15 watt fast charging support. So that was the detailed comparison of these two devices. So where does the Moto G8 Plus excel? So Moto G8 Plus excel in terms of the camera performance, the battery life, a slightly better chipset, that's a Snapdragon 665, and you get some additional features for the software, and it is also priced cheaper at 13999. Now where does the Nokia 7.2 excel? So Nokia 7.2 has a better design and excellent build quality, superior fit and finish, a slightly better display, and Android One platform makes it better in terms of software updates, because you're promised almost 2 years of software updates. And it also gives it a decent camera performance altogether. So which one should you buy? So if you're really particular about the software updates and you want a really premium looking smartphone, then you should be going for the Nokia 7.2. But otherwise, if you look at the pricing, it's almost 3.5K additional you have to pay for the Nokia 7.2. So if you're looking for a value for money device, we would definitely suggest you to go with the Moto G8 Plus. It does have polycarbonate material. It may not be as stylish as the 7.2, but in terms of the functionality wise, the Moto G8 Plus almost provides almost same functionality with a better camera and also better battery life and fast charging support. So our pick in terms of these two devices would definitely be the Moto G8 Plus. So that is a detailed comparison of the Moto G8 Plus with the Nokia 7.2. Hope you enjoyed watching this video. Do hit that like button and also hit that subscribe button for more videos. This is Nirmal signing off. Thanks for watching. Hope to see you in our next video. Have a great day.